The previous generation 5008 was too smart for its own good. A neatly packaged 7-seat MPV with some interesting powertrain options, it failed to connect with the buying public. But for the current generation it has been restyled as a more generic crossover SUV thing, still with 7 seats. More akin to the Skoda Kodiaq and Kia Sorento than the Ford S-Max and seat Alhambra. The changes bring it into line with the smaller 3008, which pioneered the same transformation, but with just 5 seats. The range starts with the 1.2 petrol, which we're driving here in manual form for the first time, and takes in a 1.6 petrol, two versions of a 1.6 diesel and three versions of a 2.0-liter diesel. Transmissions range from a 5-speed manual to an 8-speed auto, but most engines come with a choice of 6-speed manual or automatic. All are front-wheel drive. There are two big questions here. Does the SUV styled 5008, which we last drove on bumpy Portuguese roads, live up to the high demands of active family life in the Britain of 2018? And can a stingy little 3-cylinder petrol engine with a conventional manual gearbox really be the best way to shift 7 people between home, school, work, supermarket and gym? All 7 seats are independently adjustable, and the front 5 are very comfortable. The seats in the third row are not accompanied by much leg room, but they're fine for kids or adults on short journeys, if a bit tricky to get into. They fold flat into the boot, but they leave a weird gap that lets you lose luggage under row 2. Or you can remove them completely and get a boost to the already big and easily accessed boot space, and less weight, but experience suggests that once the seats are removed they're never going back in again, because they'll get buried under a pile of garden furniture in the garage and you won't be able to find them when you want them. There's a smattering of chargers, lights in sensible places, lots of stowage space and a general impression of this being a car that's been developed by people with families. The materials used, not just the leather, are agreeable to the touch, and everything seems well put together. The steering wheel, with its flat bottom and its flat top, is novelty for its own sake. In theory, it clears your legs better than a round wheel and lets you see the high-mounted instruments over the flattened top. But that's all rather dependent on your own build and stature, and how you've adjusted the wheel and seat. And it just feels wrong when you're actually steering, because every handful of rim feels different. And, as with many PSA products, the balance between touchscreen and physical switches seems all wrong. Too many functions, such as temperature adjustment, are screen only, and yet there are two rows of switches immediately beneath the screen, and a fair few others scattered around the cabin. The marketing chat may have shifted from MPV to SUV, but the heart of the 5008's appeal remains the neat, adaptable, accommodating, 7-seat interior. Don't get fooled into thinking that this is some sort of off-roader and just take it for what it is. Whatever shape of body they have, 7-seaters are in heavy demand. It's a pity that driving pleasure isn't a bigger part of the 5008 package, but when its practical virtues are so prominent it's hard to argue. Is this the right engine, gearbox combo? The 1.2 doesn't make a compelling case. The lightness of the triple has got to be a good thing, and the economy is decent for a petrol, but it really could do with some more power.